Good morning. It is day number 156. Yesterday I walked 27,725 steps, and today I'm on track for another 24,000. Wanted to give you an update. I am quitting short form video for good. I'm moving over to long form video. I realize that I can provide you a lot more value. And if I post these short form videos, it might get you into a loop of scrolling that you never get out of, and then you forget why you showed up there in the first place. And I would hate to be the person that started that loop. So here's how the new structure is going to work for this channel. Every single morning, I'm going to give you an update like I was doing with shorts, just to show you some consistency. I'm going to talk to you about the challenges that I faced the day before and the wins that I had the day before. And then that'll be the end of that video. Then I'll create a second video that's going to deep dive into a topic for the day. That way you get as much value from this channel as possible. I understand your time is not infinite, as mine is not infinite. And I just want to make sure that if you're spending your time with me, that you get something out of it and you feel good about watching. So on to my obstacles from yesterday. So let's see here. I woke up yesterday in Greenville, South Carolina, which is on the other side of the country. It's a 3-hour time difference. I'm in the Pacific time zone, and that is the Eastern time zone if you're not living in the United States. And everywhere I go, I get up at 3 o'clock in the morning. So my alarm just stays set on an everyday schedule for 3 a.m. The challenge that poses is if I am on the East Coast for a short amount of time, you know, 4 days, 5 days, and I'm coming from Pacific, that means that when I wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning here, that's the 3 o'clock I'm used to. If I wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning on the East Coast, that makes it midnight here. As a matter of fact, this morning I woke up at 12:34. It's cool to see 1, 2, 3, 4 on your clock, but waking up then isn't exactly ideal. So I stayed up for about 25 minutes and then I went back to sleep so I can get the rest of my rest to 3 o'clock. I could use it. Little cold, so I'm trying to get over that. So that's one of the challenges that I faced yesterday. Another was I didn't have enough time to get my entire walk in the morning. So my flight was at 9 a.m. And while I was in Greenville, I found that sometimes an Uber could take anywhere from 10 minutes to arrive up to 30 minutes to arrive. And that posed its own set of challenges because when I was trying to get from the hotel to the venue each day, I had to make sure that I left up to an extra half an hour just to get a car to take me to the venue. And while I would typically walk, the weather was a bit spotty. While it never rained on me in the morning, it did rain throughout the day. And I didn't want to show up to work soaked with wet shoes and have to stand in them all day. So yesterday, I opted to reserve an Uber, and I reserved it at 6:45. That got me to the airport by about 7:05. So the problem wasn't necessarily the distance or how long it took to get there, just whether or not the Uber would be available. And since I reserved it, the gentleman showed up quite a bit earlier, but that meant that I got to the airport a lot earlier. Now, I did use that time to edit some videos. The Wi-Fi at the Greenville airport is surprisingly fast. It had 100 megabit download and 100 megabit upload speeds. So I was able to bang that video out and get it uploaded really quickly compared to the hotel that had 3 megabits per second upload speed. So I would have to start an upload and just let it go. I'd order my Uber, get in my Uber, get all the way to work. And I'm sure it was still working throughout a good portion of the day. Another challenge I faced yesterday was not being able to get a proper meal in the morning. And that's because in a smaller city, a lot of things aren't open that early. So following the carnivore diet and getting something to eat that's going to fill me up before hopping on a flight can be tough. I think there was a Wolfgang Puck Express at the airport, but it's a lot of baked goods. you know, carb-loaded stuff, and it's something that I typically just opt to skip. I got a bag of pork rinds and a bottle of water, and that did me some good. I did have a bit of a delay on my flight from Greenville to Atlanta, which was my first stop, and I had planned on grabbing a bite to eat in Atlanta, but since we were delayed, and I don't know if you've ever been to the Atlanta airport, but it is massive. It's a Delta hub, and I just had to go from the A concourse to the B concourse, and it seems like just a few steps from one place to another. Nope, there's a train, and you gotta get to that train, and then you have to take the train to the next concourse, and then once you get off the train, it's still a trek. Now, fortunately, I'm training for it every day, walking, you know, getting these steps in, so the moving wasn't an issue. However, the time constraint got me to the gate right when my zone was boarding, so I did not have a chance to grab a bite to eat there. Plus, I wasn't feeling the greatest. Fortunately, I had a window seat, so I could just lean up against the window and sleep, which I really needed. But, you know, it's not all about obstacles. It is, there are wins that I also was able to enjoy, and that was getting home, putting the structure together, and getting the rest of my steps in. I had an idea yesterday that I'm going to put into video about compound interest. I want to really help the younger generation just with some tips, some things that they just didn't teach us in school, and they're likely not teaching us now, because, you know, it's the little things that we don't know that make the biggest impact in our life. If I had learned about compound interest, just the idea of it, when I was in my early teens, I mean, it would just be invaluable. I was playing with the compound interest calculator to see how long it would take for a dollar to become $1 million at 10% a year. And the answer was shocking, 140 years. But then it made me think, well, what if my great-great-grandparents knew about it and they had invested a dollar, and then my great-grandparents added more to that? You know, just over time, this is how these large families get rich and stay rich. It's because they take advantage of compound interest. And compound interest plus time is where the gold mine is. So I can't wait to dive into that in a video. And I mean, you can be on the younger side or older side, and it'll still benefit you. I didn't find out about it until about, I mean, I knew about it, but I didn't actually fully grasp the concept until about 3 or 4 years ago. But I'm glad I did, because I've been investing weekly, so it's been a game changer for me. If you look around, or look behind me, here, I'll just pan the camera out so you can see. I'm walking down this street here, and there, actually, they've been working on it for a while. And what they're doing is, at the end of the street, they're creating a bridge over a freeway, which is something I've never seen actually constructed. All of the bridges that I've seen have already been up. So the challenge here is they have to build a bridge over an active freeway. And I'm wondering how they're going to do it. I'm always fascinated by challenges that are posed by different projects and different things that people need to complete. I know the challenges that I face on a daily basis, you know, waking up early, getting 12 miles in the morning. And it's always fascinating to see how other people overcome their challenges, their obstacles. Being back in Vegas is great. I'm here for a few days, and then I'm going to Dallas, which is a 2-hour time difference. So I'll be adjusting to that on Tuesday. But I will still be back up at 3 o'clock in the morning to give you another update. Which, you know what? Like, every day I film these videos and I see the reach that they're having and I see your feedback, I'm just so grateful to do it. I'm so grateful to be in the position to be able to do it. You know, I bought all this gear a couple years ago and it just sat. And I was a bit ashamed of it because it's not cheap. And now I'm getting to use it every single day. I'm so glad that I finally made a decision to film every single day. I think it's been about 19 or 20 days straight so far that I've been putting content out there every single day. Well, look, I do hope that, you know, these daily updates are going to provide you some value and hopefully help you with your situation. Whatever you might be going through, whatever challenges you might be facing, I just I just want you to see a good example of someone that's showing up every single day. It is not warm out here. It's cold. You know, the easy decision is just to stay in bed. But I want you to see that there are people that don't take the easy route, that do show up for themselves. And I want to show you the results of that every single day. So one other thing, and then that's it for this video. And if you made it this far, I really appreciate you. Yesterday, when I got home, I spent some time putting together a 30-day walking challenge. And it'll be the pinned comment on this video and all of my other videos. So a pinned comment is a comment at the top if you didn't know. And you'll see it's a comment from me. There is a link, or if you click that link and give me your name and email, I will send you a copy of my 30-day walking challenge. And what it does is it gradually gets you from a small amount of steps per day up to a bigger amount of steps per day that can help you conquer a weight loss goal. My only ask from you is that if you start it, finish it. Because everyone I've ever walked with, like if they stuck with me throughout the whole walk, they end up branching out on their own. My brother, he was out here for SEMA, and we had a pretty good walk, about an 8 to 10 mile walk. And then each day he was then inspired to get out and walk from his hotel, which was in Mandalay Bay, to the convention center and just keep an eye on his steps throughout the day. Convention center's huge, so it's cool to just spark that new interest in people and get them moving. That's all I want for my community. I want a healthy, happy community, and anyone is welcome to join. So once again, if you click that link in the pinned comment and just put your name and email in, I will send you my 30-day walking challenge. Please understand it is not automated at this point. I just created it yesterday, but I want to get it to you as soon as possible so that you can start on getting to the best version of you you can be. And remember, I'll be showing up here every single day to give you an update and also to encourage you to keep going. All right, I will catch you in the next video. Bye for now.